It's Alex and Ronnie here. We're about to work a core strength workout. It's about 25 minutes nonstop from when I hit it right now. Now we're starting out with an alternating leg extension. Start with the knees over the hips, the belly brace, the low back on the floor. Push a leg extension, tap the heel, and pull right back in. It's not about pushing the base right now, we're just warming things up. As you push, keep your stomach braced and keep your low back from popping up off the floor. Head and shoulders stay on the floor as you extend. Just pushing a full leg extension. Getting warm before I start to kick your butt. Perfect. Take a breath. We're going to be working right into a double leg extension. Same thing, both legs push out, belly braced. Keep the stomach tight the entire time so as you push out, the low back doesn't pop off the floor. Try not to lose tension in your stomach. So as your heels hit, keep the stomach tight and don't let the back arch. Again, we don't want to go into this position in between repetitions. Keep the belly tight. Should start to feel it. Drop the heels, set them into a big bridge. Palms face the ceiling, drive the hips as high as you can. Squeeze the butt, give the hips a little stretch. Every breath you take out, see if you can drive a little bit higher. Perfect, relax hips out. Lift both legs to the ceiling. Belly braced, one leg at a time. Try to tap the heel to the floor. Try to keep your shoulders on the floor. Again, it's a controlled movement. Your back stays on the floor and your stomach stays tight through each leg lift and leg lowering. Try to keep your top leg as straight into the air as you can. If you have tight hamstrings, this one's gonna fight you a little bit. Warming up. Perfect. Bend the knees, drop them.
Bridges for 15 seconds.
We're gonna drive right back up into the bridge, as high as you can push. Squeeze the butt. Again, palms open up to face the ceiling. Again, every breath out, see if you can drive higher and higher into extension. Good job, guys. Hips hit the floor. Working right into our double leg lifts. Again, belly's braced, tap the heels, pull to the top. Your goal, again, is to keep the stomach so tight, the low back never pops off the floor. When the legs hit the ground, keep your tension again. We're not allowing that tension to drop until we hit the end of this set. Shoulder blades still on the floor. Guys. Bend the knees, drop the heels. Nice work.
Thoracic rotations for 30
seconds. Hold the knees up over the hips. We're gonna let the knees drop side to side. Try to squeeze your knees together. Try to keep your wingspan open so your shoulders, elbows, and wrists stay on the floor as well as you can. Just get a couple passes each way. Connect your breathing with the stretch. Take a breath out on the bottom so you're not holding your breath. If you feel stuck, take a big breath in and out to drop the shoulders. All right, pull the knees to center.
Single leg bridge.
Left drive into your bridge, seconds. Palms facing the ceiling. Lift your left leg up over the hips and stabilize. Just hold. Now your heels planted, you're not letting the butt drop. You're keeping the hips extended. Drop the foot, reset your bridge higher.
Single leg,
same thing for the other leg. Lift up, stabilize. Don't let those hips drop. Keep the butt held high. Heel stays planted. Drop the foot. Relax the butt down.
Low back.
Pull both knees and tight to the chest. Pull the shoulders down and back. Take a couple deep breaths. Every time you exhale, see if you can pull in a little bit bigger stretch on that low back. Every breath though. Again, shoulders aren't here, but they're down to the floor.
Perfect. Next is core flexion and extension.
All right, we're gonna be working right into those abs. Start with the arms held overhead. We lift the legs and reach for the toes. Tap both sides as lightly as you can. We're going through three movements in a row, starting with the most difficult first. Again, it's about keeping your lower back on the floor so you maintain tension in the stomach. Good. Take a breath. We're gonna work into a leg extension. As we pull in, we're gonna reach for the heels. Pull in and crunch. As you push out, maintain the tension as the heels down. You can relax the head down the floor in between repetitions. Try to get the shoulder blades up slightly as you pull as much range from your ribs to your hips as you can. Perfect. Now choke the heels in close to the butt. Same movement without the leg extension. Pull the knees in, crunch, drop the heels. Again, keep tension in your stomach each repetition. So as the legs drop, if you put your hands on your stomach, it stays tight the entire time in. Don't lose that tension. Low back's on the floor. Nice job, guys. Big bridge as high as we can. Now again, just like before, every repetition, we're going to take a breath out and drive higher. Release and exhale, drive higher. Pulsing in that top range as much as we can get over those hips. Keep the heels pointed. Keep driving. Knees are over the ankles. Good job, guys.
Roll up to toe touch for 20 seconds.
Arms overhead. A little momentum through the arms. Roll in and pull yourself in for a hamstring stretch. Hold for a moment. Keep the tension in the stomach as you slowly lay back. Again, arms go right back into the next repetition. Keep breathing through. Perfect. Pull the knees right back into the chest. Feel the release on the lower back again.
Release for 20 seconds.
Again, we're just breathing in. Take your left leg out on the floor and hold on to the right leg. Take a few breaths with the single leg extension. Try to get your other leg out straight on the floor as you pull the knee in. Again, breathe. Switch it out. We're gonna flow right through that round. One more time. All right, starting off with the legs on the floor.
Bench is lateral core strength and stability.
Hi, what?
Side plank left for 1 minute.
No. All right, set up in your side plank. Feet are stacked, drive it up, lock in, find your balance. Shoulders over the elbow, hips drive high. Through your bony, give yourself a kidney partner high five. Now your goal isn't just to squeeze the hips up, it's also to keep a neutral spine. So squeeze your butt slightly forward so that your head, your shoulders, your hips, your heels are all in a straight line. And maintain, we're here for a minute. We need to start making up some side plank stories. Things are warm now. Heart rate's up slightly. Now if this is too tough, drop the bottom knee to the floor, continue driving the hips up, squeezing your butt slightly forward. Yep. There you go, guys. You still got it? Hold it. All right, there is no recovery. We go right over to the other elbow. Same setup. Shoulder over the wrist. Good, drive the hips up. Lock it in. Perfect. Again, good alignment. The hips drive up and the hips drive slightly forward. Maintain. And just breathe with it. Good job, guys. You can remember your bottom option if you need to. Bottom knee can bend to 90 degrees. Keep those hips driving up from the knee. Your shoulders bothering you? Usually the weakest link when you first start doing side planks is the rotator cuff. Use your options when you need to. Job at waking things up. Still on level one of our lateral stability. Alright. Side planks are fun. Hold on. 3 seconds, 2, 1, and relax it down. Alright. We're going to be working into the side plank again.
For 30 seconds.
Shoulders over the elbows to start. We're going to roll to the side plank. Look at the top hand. We're going to roll through and stabilize the other side. Now we're turning the hips and shoulders together as well as we can. It's not a fast movement. It's a stability movement. So your hips and shoulders stay square the entire time as you roll through the heels and the toes. There you go, guys. Nice. All right. We're going to go right back into our thoracic rotations. Arms are nice and wide. Knees are over the hips. Let the knees drop from side to side. Take a breath out every time on the bottom again. Connect your stretch by breathing through the movement. Again, when you hit a sticking point or you can't go any further, again, one side to side and the other, give it a little bit more time. Try to squeeze our knees together slightly. All right, guys, we work right back into the side plank again.
Step for 45 seconds.
Now we hold the side plank. Find the balance, lock it in. Now the top leg steps to the front, and then right up and over steps to the back. Now our goal is the body stays still as we make that step up and over. We're not trying to rush through it. We're trying to remain stable. Try not to let the hips drop. Keep them held up as you make your step up and over. Just breathing with it. Option is to drop to the bottom knee and do the same movement, just stepping forward and backward, keeping your butt tensed up so you're driving the hips forward slightly. Perfect, guys. And your lateral side of your shoes on the floor, that's gonna give you some extra balance and stability. Good job, guys. Working right over to the other side again.
Side plank right with step for
shoulders over the elbow. Stack the feet or bend the bottom knee. Again, it's all about stability. Keep those hips held high as you make that step up and over. Just breathing with it. Keeping your body as still as you can, maintaining that stability. Feel your obliques talking a little bit as you drive your hips from the floor. Sorry,
kick each other.
Yeah, kick your partner if she's bothering you. All right, guys. We go right back into our front to side plank. This time we make a step up and over every time. So we roll to the side plank, stabilize, make one step up and over. Staying stable as we can, rolling through to the other side. And we're not rushing through the movement. We're controlling the movement as well as we can. Hips and shoulders, again, staying square as well as we can. Not letting our hips drop as we make that step. Again, when you have to hit the side plank, if you have to hit the knee, drop the knee, make the step back and forth, and then roll it right back through. Second check, guys. Every time you roll through the middle shoulders, are right on top of the elbows. Almost through it, guys.
Thoracic rotations for 30 seconds.
This time when we go to our thoracic rotations, I want you to drop the knees to the side. If they aren't hitting the floor, take your top in and pull them into the floor. Look at the open palm and take 3 deep breaths. Every time you breathe out again. Try to drop your shoulder, elbow, and wrist closer to the floor. Job, pull it right through to the other side. One more set on this side. Again, a few deep breaths. Alright. Alright, guys, we're on the feet. It's all about the butt now.
Lunge left for 45 seconds.
Now we're working on your left leg, stepping back. A floating lunge looks like this. We're keeping the heel planted, trying to keep the back leg off the floor as much as we can as we push up and stand tall. So we're leading the knee into the floor by the heel right here. We're trying to use our lead leg, the leg that stays in place all the way through. Now if you're with Ronnie and you can't get that range of motion, just work what range you can control. Stop when you start to lose stability. You need to put a little bit of weight in the toes. You can. We're really trying to stay away from that. We're trying to float through it. Think about pushing your butt down and backwards as you load. That's going to get the hips and glutes more active. And your heel stays planted right through the entire range of motion. Perfect. Quick shake. We're going to go right over to the opposite leg. Same thing. One side may be your stronger side, so if one side's a little bit stronger, keep working what range of motion you can. Your heel has to stay planted through the full range of motion. We're gonna be coming back and doing this drill again in a little bit. Hips will be warmed up a little bit more when we get there. So just get a feel for the movement. Long breathing now. your knee in line with the toes as well as you can as you're low in the position. Pushing your butt back, keep the glutes involved. Nice work. All right, quick shake of the legs. We're going right back to the other leg again, tipping in from the hips for a deadlift. As you tip in, you reach with the same leg that goes backwards. As you stand tall, we're gonna come up with a little hop, catch your balance. We're tipping right back in from the hips, trying to stay square with the hips and the shoulders to the floor. We're trying to stay on the same leg through the entire round right here. Try to keep your knee over the ankle as you tip in from the hips. If you can, try to get parallel to the floor. Good job, guys. Again, try not to rotate as you hit that position, so you're doing your best to stay square. I'm starting to get tired. Here you go. Quick shake. All right, guys. Working right over to the other side. All right, same thing on the other side. As you tip in, knee stays over the ankle, hinging from the hips, keeping the knee over the ankle. As you stand up, little swing through the leg, catch your balance again. Once you got it, tip right back in. Again, same arm, sag leg, reach out for a little counterbalance. Again, one side may be easier than the other, just do your best. Stand tall through the hips as you swing the leg at the top. Here we go. 7 seconds, guys. Again, trying to stay as square as we can as that leg starts to get tired. Here you go, quick shake. Awesome. All right. Time to bring up your inner dog.
30 seconds.
Shoulders over the wrist. We're lifting the leg to the side, keeping our hips square to the floor. We're going to bring it right back down and push the heel up to the ceiling. Bring it right back in and back out to the side. As you're opening up the hips for the fire hydrant, try not to rotate your body to get the leg higher. So the body stays as still as you can through both movements. Keep your toes and heel choking close to the butt as well as you can. So you're not trying to push from the foot, you're trying to push all that work through the hip right here. Now we're gonna keep the same leg extended out the entire round. As we hold the position, we're going to try to curl the heel as close to the butt as we can, and then release through a straight leg. Curl the heel as close to the butt as you can, and release through a straight leg. Now tuck your chin. Look right at the floor. There you go. Try to keep that leg in a straight line. We're going to try and keep everything square to the floor from our hips and our shoulders. Whew. You feel it?
Yeah.
I got sweat dripping off my nose. Perfect. Working right over to the other side.
Rest for 15 seconds.
Shoulders are over the wrist. Again, same concept when you go to the fire hydrant. You don't want to try to open up the hips by rotating the whole body. You want to keep everything as square to the floor as you can as we open up the hip and feel the outside of the hips working to pull the leg. Again, same position, opposite leg. Again, pull the knee to the side first. Once you get it up, roll it back down. Keep that knee at about a 90 degree the entire time. Think about opening up the hips, squeezing the glute, and dropping it right back in. Good job, guys. Again, we're gonna be coming back to these movements in a little bit. Just get a feel for them. Try not to let your back arch as you push the heel to the ceiling for the donkey kick. Good, take a quick breath. You're going right back into the leg extension with the hamstring curl. Again, shoulders are over the wrist. Push that leg all the way back straight. As you curl the heel to the butt, try to keep the body as still as you can. Feel that hamstring tighten up as much as you can. Every curl, heel to the butt. The rest of the body, constant move. We're keeping that neutral spine as well as we can. 5 seconds, guys. Very good job right there. All right, guys, pop right back on the feet.
15 seconds.
We're gonna be going right back into that round, right again from, again, the floating lunge. Again, hips are warmed up a little bit more now. Try to increase that range of motion a little bit if you're not getting on the floor yet. Again, key is to push your butt back slightly. As you push your butt back, it's gonna make it easier to keep the heel planted. So as you go down again, the leg hovers as we load the position, knees in line with the toes, push to the top and stand tall. Try to keep all that weight in the lead leg. Ready? tip in from the hips slightly as you send the butt back to keep the heel down. Knee still stays in line with the toes. It's a very short length in our stride, so we're not trying to step back very far. Still trying to keep all that work in the lead leg. Do you feel the legs working through the hips a little bit more this round?
Oh yeah,
I definitely do. Almost out of this one, guys. Quick shake. Very good job.
Take it right back to the other side.
Same thing, chest up, push the butt back, tip it slightly again, try to keep all that work in the lead leg, even if it slows you down a little bit. Real grunts, people. Less than 10 seconds. Try to do the hips to get tall every rep. Quick shake.
We can get back into the single leg deadlift with a little hop out of it. Again, the same leg that goes back is the same arm that goes forward.
Tip from the hips, keeping the knee over the ankle. Once you come up to the top, a little swing through, catch your balance, stabilize, tip it right back in. Again, we're trying to stay in the hips. So it's not about bending the knee as much as you can. It's about really tipping in, trying to get to about parallel to the floor if you can. Do your best again to stay square with the hips and shoulders. Yeah, balance gets tougher as the legs get tighter. 12 seconds, guys. Almost done on this leg. Oh, shake it out, shake it out. Working right over to the other side. Again, tip it from hips. Arm and leg stretch as we drop our body to parallel. Push out, a little hop, reset. Keep doing your best to stay parallel. I know, it's tough, it's tough. Heel stays planted through the whole movement. Shake it out if you need to, you got this, Ryan. Continue tipping in from it, stretching out the hips. 10 seconds, guys. I got it. I don't got it. Oh man, legs are burning. Back to our fire hydrant, guys. Opposite leg from weight like we were just working on. Same thing. Hips stay square. Open up the hips, keeping the body still. Drop it back in, push the heel up towards the ceiling. Keep your knee bent at 90 degrees the whole way through. Think about the hip muscle. So right now I'm working on my left hip, trying to open up as much as I can without the other body parts moving along with it. As much range of motion as I can get and feel it squeeze for a moment. All right, guys, working back into our leg extension with the curl. Same quadruped position, push the leg out, same leg. We're square to the floor yet. We're gonna curl the heel in as far as we can, and then release to a straight leg. Again, hips and shoulders are staying square to the floor as well as you can. Hamstrings are burning. Less than 10 seconds. Release, good job, guys. All right, we're gonna be working back into the other side. Same focus, don't try to cheat the movement by turning the rest of the body, keep everything square as well as you can. That's gonna help you connect to the outside hip. Shoulders over the wrist, knees under the hips, stay square, going into the fire hydrant first. Again, open up the hips as far as you can. Let it drop under control. Lift the heel to the ceiling. Try not to arch the back as you push the heel up. Body stays still, core tight. Great job, guys. All right, guys. guys. Back to our lady cinch again. Shoulders over the wrist, yeah, back's nice and flat, neutral spine. Good leg pushes back to straight. Curl the heels, close together the butt. Easy release to a straight leg. Core stays tight, the body stays still. Hold on, guys. Nice work, 6 seconds left. Way to maintain.
Burning. Good job, guys. All right. We're going right back into the core round I thought we were doing earlier. We're going flat on the back, working back into our V crunch movement. We've got 6 seconds before we go in. You're almost at the very end of the workout right now. Last big step. Now we're going to V crunch start. Flat on our back, arms held overhead.
Next is core crunch.
Same set as last time when we worked through these. Leg lift, reaching for our toes as far as you can. Belly tight all the way through the leg lowering. Keep that low back on the floor by keeping the stomach held and braced. Last big set on the abs, guys. You're almost at the end of this one. Nice job, guys. Now we're going to be working into a crunch, pulling the knees in now. As you pull the knees in, get the shoulder blades up and crunch. Again, tap the floor lightly so you don't lose that strength and tension in the abs. Keep them under tension through the whole set. Back's not arching off the floor, we're maintaining well. All right, heels drop. Same movement, again, feel the tension in the stomach. Pull the knees in, drop the heels. Again, as you're going up and down right here, feel your stomach. Are those abs staying engaged all the way through the heel tap and the crunch? If they're not, focus. Good job, guys. Perfect. All right, drop the heels. As much range as you can get out of your bridge again. Arms wide, palms open, drive the hips up as high as you can. Now these muscles are awake. Every breath out. Drive higher. Every breath out. See if you can increase that range of motion through the hip extension. Almost at the end, guys. All right, we're working our leg extension crunch again. We're gonna pulse for three every time we pull in. Pull in and crunch. One, two, three. Belly tight. Keep the tension. Pull right back in. One, two, three. Leg extension. Tap. Pull right back in. One, two, three. 15 seconds, check, guys. Hold on to that tension. One, two, three. Come on, guys. Hold on. One, two, three. Give me one more rep. Pull in tight. One, two, three. Drop the heels. All right. Grab your knees, pull them in tight.
Back release for 20 seconds.
Again, pull in, take a few deep breaths.
Every time you exhale, see if you can pull a little bit further. Pull your toes up towards your own forehead. Get a little bit more out of it. Shoulder blades are on the floor. You guys ready to finish this? Yeah, you there, honey? You ready?
Yeah.
Flip over. Front plank for 1 minute, holding stationary. This is it. Shoulders over the elbows, just raise. Now, when you're planking, you want to keep a neutral spine. That means hips are square to the floor. We're trying not to let the low back arch this way. When our abs are getting lazy, we're trying not to push the butt up into the air. We're trying to get rid of that low back arch by pulling our tailbone and curling it in by bracing our lower abdominals. Something that can help you to feel that, think about pulling your elbows towards your toes like you're trying to pull yourself into the front plank. Once you get the elbows pulling towards the toes, you should feel those abs light up a little bit more. This is it, guys. Hold on for 20 seconds. Finishing strong. You can do this, guys. Stand right to the end. I'm gonna give you your countdown soon. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Whoo!
Good job, you guys.
Number 1 finish.
Thanks for joining Ronnie and I through a good core workout. Keep challenging yourself as you get better and better at that one. Try to increase range of motion. Try to hold onto the tension in the abs through all those sets. Really get the most out of it. Bye-bye.